Shaolin Temple. Home of an ancient sect of warrior monks. Proud defenders of a 1,000-year-old tradition until now. Today, a new generation is reinventing Shaolin Temple as the Kung Fu monks take on a challenge like none other. Doing business in the 21st century. The Kung Fu monks of Shaolin Temple. For more than 1,000 years, they have protected China's emperors and defended their nation with their dazzling fighting skills. A formidable legacy. And a lot to live up to if you're only 10 years old. Welcome to boot camp, Shaolin style.
Two hands on the foot. Straighten the body.
This is Liu Zhenzhong, one of Shaolin's youngest novice monks. Zhenzhong lived with his parents in Fujian province until he was selected for a place at the temple. That was a year ago. Since then, he's lived at Shaolin Temple with more than 40 other novice monks, all of them handpicked from kung fu schools all over China, training 3 hours in the morning, 2.5 hours in the afternoon, 365 days a year. Always under the watchful eye of Yan Xu, Shaolin's drill sergeant.
Point your feet straight.
His job, to turn this bunch of kids into real kung fu monks.
Keep your back straight. Kick properly. Hurry up, hurry up. Faster, faster, faster.
The Chinese words kung fu evoke honor and glory, but they translate into English simply as hard work. It's a punishing regime, even for these boys. The best of the best. That's why Shaolin calls its novices the hopefuls. Back home, Each of these boys was a star. But now, they're all competing with each other. Each hoping he'll be one of the few who'll eventually get what they've come here for. A place on the A-Team. Shaolin performance teams travel the world, captivating audiences with dazzling kung fu displays. It's a ticket out of rural China to a life of stardom. But there's only one way to get there. By coming here. Shaolin Monastery. Nestled in the Songshan Mountains, 846 kilometers southwest of Beijing. And a long, lonely 1,000 kilometers from Zhenzhong's home. Life at Shaolin's a big adjustment for these boys. And Zhenzhong's still adjusting.
When I first arrived here, I missed my home a lot. I cried every day. After a while, I got used to it. I have a lot of friends in martial art class. They treat me like a little brother.
One of Zhenzhong's big brothers at the temple is 18-year-old Zhou Jinbo. He's been here for 6 years and has his own plan to make the traveling team. Jinbo's specialty is iron kung fu. To master it, a monk must train to numb pain from a specific part of his body. And Jinbo has chosen his head.
It was very hard in the beginning. Every class, we stood on our heads at least for half an hour. It hurt so much. I wanted to cry, but I didn't want my teacher to see me. So I cried at night in my bed.
Jinbo's taken the pain for a full 2 years of hard training, hoping that mastering iron kung fu will help him beat the competition and make an exhibition team. Seeking to fulfill his Shaolin quest by reaching deep into kung fu's traditions.
I want to travel around the world and perform, make Shaolin Temple even more famous.
But another of young Zhenzhong's mates, Dong Dong, is hoping he'll become a star by doing something never done before. Dong Dong's extraordinary talents have earned him a place in a very special touring team. For the first time in over 1,000 years, Shaolin monks are learning movements created by outsiders. Western outsiders. Belgian choreographer Sidi Labi Shakawi and Polish composer Szymon Broska have spent 2 months here developing a new Shaolin show for one of the world's most prestigious dance venues, London's Sadler's Wells. It's part Shaolin Kung Fu, part interpretive dance. But it's all new for these monks.
It's very, very heavy scene for them to do because they used to normally do one little sequence and then say thank you and go. And now they have to keep on moving and moving and moving until exhaustion.
As if the very concept of marrying dance and kung fu wasn't radical enough, cities just decided to introduce some new props. 21 very large boxes.
And with 21 boxes, you can create an infinite number of constructions. You could create a temple, you could create a graveyard, you can create a zoo with cages. There's so many ways.
As they struggle with the new props, the dancer monks are mindful they've got just 2 months left before they've got to perform this never-before-attempted routine in front of one of the most sophisticated audiences on Earth. And before they can leave for London, they've got to please an even tougher critic. Shaolin's senior abbot, Shir Yongxin, looks as traditional as any other Buddhist monk, especially this morning. As he presides over one of Shaolin's holiest rituals. Every year in March, Shaolin honors its deceased abbots. At a cluster of 200 stone pagodas, standing to the west of the temple. Each a memorial to a former abbot. Shir Yongxin's predecessor, Shir Shuxi, died in 2007. Shir Shuxi's pagoda is carved with images of the changes he saw in his lifetime. Jet air travel, computers, video cameras, icons of the modern world. But for Shir Yongxin, coping with change is just a routine part of daily life. The abbot is determined that as China races into the 21st century, Shaolin Temple won't be left behind. Every day from dawn to dusk, Shaolin transforms itself from Buddhist temple to Buddha land. One of China's top tourist destinations. For 100 yuan, about 15 US dollars, visitors get access to the inner temple's most sacred relics. And if they're willing to part with more of their money, they can take home some officially blessed souvenirs. The chance to watch the warrior monks practice packs the house day after day. As Shaolin's apostle of change, Abbot Shir Yongxin's had to become more than a spiritual leader. He's now also a brand manager, looking after one of China's best-known exports, Shaolin Incorporated. A multi-million dollar business with investment portfolios and property, media, tourism, and healthcare. And the brand's going global with links to temples and kung fu schools in the USA and Europe. At its corporate headquarters, web designers and a business director take direction from the CEO. Despite his shaved head and saffron robes, Shiryong Shin isn't like any other Shaolin abbot. And the new Shaolin's worldwide fame is inspiring praise and criticism and a lot of imitators. In the neighboring city of Dongfeng, thousands of students support a kung fu economy. Dongfeng's biggest martial arts school has two campuses and 25,000 students. All the schools promise instruction by bona fide Shaolin masters. The signs out front say Shaolin Temple, but their huge Western-style buildings suggest that something's very different. And it is. These kids are learning wushu, a highly competitive sport version of kung fu. Shaolin monks don't compete, but wushu students do. They can win trophies, but they're not the real thing. Only the most talented wushu graduates can hope to earn a place on a Shaolin Temple display team. The best most of these thousands can hope for is a job as a security guard or policeman. Even at Shaolin Temple, hopefuls who don't make a traveling display team face a much tougher future. Working as martial arts teachers at wushu schools, or hiring themselves out as bodyguards. Which is why this man's opinion really matters. Yan Da is the temple's master in charge of martial art monks. He decides who's got what it takes to join one of Shaolin's display teams. And he's not an easy man to impress.
There's a saying in Chinese, good students come from strict teachers. The only way for them to become successful in the future is if we are strict on them.
In only a few more days, Yan Da and the other senior monks will pick this year's traveling teams. All the hopefuls know that discipline will be the key to success. Along with their teacher, Yan Xu, Jinbo and his mates never stop practicing the ancient routines they hope will make them stars. Feats of power and endurance that defy rational explanation. Can concentrate their body's energy, or qi, into a force so powerful that over the centuries, they've dented holes in the temple floor. Only a perfect harmony of body and mind can generate that kind of power. something the hopefuls know very well. As the big day approaches, they renew their devotion to Shaolin's Buddhist heritage. Jinbo and some of his friends make a pilgrimage to the place where Shaolin Kung Fu started. High up in the Songshan Mountains. According to legend, a Buddhist monk called Bodhidharma, or Dhammo, meditated in a cave high above the monastery for 9 years. Developing the world-famous tradition the Chinese call Chan and the Japanese Zen. If that's true, Dhammo would have been all too familiar with the aches and pains of prolonged sitting. Which is why, the legends say, he invented a set of body movements to help relieve the strain. Movements that evolved into Kung Fu. Today, Shaolin Kung Fu has over 700 moves. You can't do things like this unless your mind has mastered it. Even at today's Shaolin, without spiritual commitment, there's no success. Today, Zhen Zhong is getting some religious instruction from one of the temple's oldest ordained monks. 60-year-old Xu Yong Chans spent most of his life at Shaolin and offers his wisdom to young hopefuls.
You study martial arts as well as meditation. You need to integrate Chan into martial arts.
What is Chan, teacher?
Chan is everywhere. There is Chan when you lie, and when you stand, when you walk, and when you sit. It is quite magical and quite meaningful.
Zhen Zhong listens respectfully and tries his best to practice Chan principles as part of his Kung Fu training. But he and his friends aren't here just to become Buddhist monks.
Come on, Kenneth.
Shaolin's roots may be ancient and sacred, but today, Hollywood's an effective recruiter. Hopefuls like Zhen Zhong dream of being the next Kung Fu megastar.
My favorite Kung Fu star in films is Jackie Chan. I watch a lot of his films.
The wars and upheavals of 20th century China nearly killed Shaolin. For centuries, Kung Fu had been a powerful defense against all enemies. But it was no match for machine guns and artillery. In the 1920s, battling warlords tore China apart. and Shaolin became a casualty of war. In 1928, a local militia set fire to its main halls. Destroying Buddhist icons and sacred scriptures, leaving a 1,000-year-old tradition in ruins. When Shiryong Qian began his life as a Shaolin novice, there were only 15 monks left. It was a time he remembers all too well.
When I first came here, I worked in the fields. Everything was destroyed. It was a painful time. We all cried.
Shaolin Temple seemed destined for a slow death. And then, in the 1980s, that destiny changed, thanks to two men. One was Chinese leader Deng Xiaoping, who proclaimed that to get rich is glorious and unleashed China's boundless entrepreneurial energy after decades of Marxist suppression. The other was Jet Li. In 1982, Li was an unknown Hong Kong actor and martial arts expert when he starred in The Shaolin Temple, a cinematic tale of honor and revenge, showcasing his dazzling kung fu skills and lionizing ancient Shaolin's warrior monks. Since the 1980s, China's exploding economy and the worldwide rage for martial arts films have lifted Shaolin out of the ashes and thrust it into the 21st century. Abbot Shiryong Xin's mission is managing his temple's reincarnation in the new China. And that's taking him where no Shaolin abbot's gone before. The Communist Party's National People's Congress in Beijing. Shiryong Xin's attending as a delegate from Henan province, representing Shaolin's interests in a sea of worldly power. He's something of a star here. People know he's a mover and a shaker. And he's rumored to be one of the country's more influential men. Star power, an open mind, and the government's patronage have all helped Shiryong Xin to resurrect his ancient temple's fame and fortune. Sidi Labi Shekaui's about to find out if his avant-garde dance routine will push the Shaolin Temple display team too far. Dong Dong and his fellow monks have been working hard to realize their dream. A standing ovation from an adoring London audience. And the temple's always encouraged its visiting renowned choreographer to do his thing.
Came here in May, I met Master Yan Da, who was not at all what I expected of a monk, actually. When I was telling him that some of the monks, the way they move, reminded me of some hip-hop dancers that I knew. He was like, yeah, but if you want to work with them in a hip-hop manner, go for it. And I was like, I was looking at him like, are you joking? And now this here.
Sidi's hoping his never-before-attempted blend of dance and kung fu will really connect Western audiences with the Shaolin monks. But will it connect with Abbot Shiryong Shin? If he doesn't like it, the London premiere will be over before it begins. Iron Monk Jinbo's pursuing stardom the old-fashioned way. But that doesn't make his quest any easier. Jinbo might be able to break iron bars with his head, but he needs more than one trick to make the traveling team. Kung Fu stars must master one of Shaolin's traditional weapons. Staffs, swords, or chains. Jinbo's specialty is the broadsword and chain, a potentially lethal combination, except that these weapons were never meant to take lives. Buddhism discourages violence, and the killing of any living thing is strictly prohibited. If you take a closer look at Jinbo's sword and chain, you'll see they're made from wood, tin, or some other non-lethal material. Shaolin's signature weapon is a wooden staff called a bung. Hundreds of years ago, during the Ming Dynasty, the martial monks disarmed their opponents with it. In those days, they did plenty of fighting, always with the emperor's permission, against enemies who tried to plunder Shaolin's riches and destroy its political power. One period, the temple's standing army numbered 2,000 warrior monks. That's why weapon training survives to this day as a prestigious part of a Kung Fu star's performance. And a commemoration of Shaolin's fierce determination to survive. Less than a week, Yan Da will make his decision on who will make the A squad and travel the world performing Shaolin Kung Fu. And who will have to go back to basic training.
The mind, the breath, and the strength must work together to win.
Go.
Jinbo and Zhen Zhong have high hopes. But just days before the big decision, Zhen Zhong suffers some seriously bad luck.
Teacher, my foot is injured.
How did that happen?
I fell in a ditch when I was jogging the other day.
Does it hurt?
Yes.
Jinbo, take Luo Zhen Zhong to the doctor.
The timing couldn't be worse. One word from the doctor could keep Zhen Zhong off the display team and cripple his dreams.
When did you twist your ankle?
A couple of days ago.
Take your shoes off. Let me have a look.
It hurts when I walk or run.
The doctor's usual prescription. Suck it up and get back to your training. And prove that you're a tough Shaolin monk.
The children here can endure a lot. Unless they are badly hurt, they will practice with injuries.
But Zhen Zhong's ankle is badly hurt. He's going to be out of action for at least a week. That could ruin his chances of making the A squad and winning a place in this year's touring display team. Suddenly, Zhen Zhong's year of hard work could be for nothing. The day of decision begins just like any other. But for the novice Kung Fu monks, it's the biggest day of their young lives. Iron Monk Jinbo is going to need as much sustenance as he can get to prove to Yan Da he's ready for selection in the A squad. But Zhen Zhong's going to need more than food to help heal his injury. It'll take a miracle to fix his ankle in time for practice. At morning training, Zhen Zhong can only watch as the other hopefuls perform a routine Shaolin monks have practiced for centuries. Seven-star Kung Fu. It's the last chance to impress.
The seven-star routine is a required traditional routine for every monk here. When we perform, we do seven-star routine because it is better looking. Wang Lu goes to South Korea. Wei Huqiang goes to Australia. Is he on the list?
Now comes the moment they've all been training for. Time for the teachers to announce who's going back to the basics and who will soon be packing their bags for the opportunity of a lifetime.
This afternoon, we're dividing you into two groups.
Jinbo has made the A-team. Soon he will realize his dream of traveling and performing around the world, helping make Shaolin even more famous. Zhen Zhong's ankle hasn't healed, and he hasn't made the cut. But Yan Da and Yan Shu have a special assignment for him, teaching one of the new recruits. Today is also the day when Shaolin's most radical new innovation will learn its fate. Shaolin's first ever East-West dance collaboration could take the martial monks in a bold new direction. But first, it needs the temple's official seal of approval. And that means a private performance for Abbot Shi Yongxin. The abbot's just come back from Beijing, and he's asked to see the dancers perform. If he doesn't like what he sees, the rest of the world will never see it. The command performance is only minutes away, and Sidi's a little anxious.
It's kind of a big thing because he hasn't seen anything except some pictures. He's seen some pictures of the performance, I mean of the ideas, but he's never really seen which monks are in it and what they're doing and stuff like that. So I'm very curious to know what he thinks.
With just a simple gesture, the abbot shows his approval of Sidi's work. Everyone's relieved. Soon these monks will be heading for London, where they'll be footing it with the best professional dancers in the business. Thanks to an abbot who takes chances and believes in change. Shi Yongxin's transforming Shaolin from a cultural relic on the brink of extinction into a thriving capitalist enterprise. Some say he's ruining Shaolin's spiritual integrity, but he's willing to take the heat. For him, Shaolin is change.
I believe if our first teacher, Master Bodhidharma, were alive today, he would have done the same to adapt to today's society. Only when you respect the reality and adapt to the present time can you survive and develop.
Iron Monk Jinbo will soon be heading overseas to join the ranks of Shaolin's top performers. And young Zhen Zhong? His foot's healed, and he's finally rejoined his friends as they fight on for positions in future display teams.
I think I am not very good at the moment. I will work harder and become better so that I can perform all over the country.
Zhen Zhong and his classmates may not ever become fully ordained martial monks, but after years of training and meditation in this temple, they will always take a little bit of Shaolin with them. For over 1,000 years, it's kept its spiritual heart intact while surviving in a changing world. Now, China's changing again. And Shaolin is surviving, even prospering, by changing with it. But for those who love this ancient place and devote their lives to it, Shaolin Temple always will be what it always has been, a fortress of enlightenment and a sanctuary for the soul.